Well, again, this is one of those things I drive by 5-6 times a week, and I never stop to visit. And it is Loghurst, right here on Route 224 in Canfield, part of the Canfield Heritage Foundation. And the site manager is Janelle Donahue. And Janelle, you, off camera, this really is an interesting dwelling with a rich history.
I love it. It goes back to 1805 when Conrad Neff built it out of the 12-inch log-hewn logs of chestnut. This was added on after 1826. It's the new kitchen.
Yeah, it's the new kitchen. I mean, but this
when they remodeled.
This was inhabited until the 80s.
Yes.
The 1980s.
Yes. Josephine lived here.
Really interesting.
It was built in 1805 and Josephine donated around 1976 to 1980, sometime in that time frame. She donated it to the Western Reserve Historical Society. Well,
And you were doing a wonderful job maintaining this. And
is there a
lot of interest when you have the tours? Do you see
They love it, yes. We do Girl Scout troops that come in because they have to earn a historical badge.
Uh-huh.
So they will do that in Candle Dipping Forum. And when people come, they love it. It's just people drive by.
I mean, this is really part of our heritage, our history here in the Valley. Mm-hmm. And you drive by it a million times a day. This is a busy road.
Yes. It was the main road from Pittsburgh going to Akron and up to Cleveland. And it was nothing more than a dirt path through the woods when he first built this house here.
So where did all these acquisitions come from? Are these all from the household, or are these just true to the period?
Most of it's true to the period. It's right now the setting is around 1900 when the last family, the Kyles, had it. This is Jacob Barnes's rifle. His family donated it to us.
That is nice. This is the ice box from the period. Can I touch
yes.
it?
Yeah.
Look, and then you put the little ice.
The ice would
there.
Go in the bottom.
Yeah.
And these are the ice tongs where they would pull it out.
Now this room is a lot more cozy. I guess it would be this wall-to-wall carpet.
Originally, yeah, because the setting that in these rooms are now from the Kyles.
Okay.
From 1900s. This was this was Conrad Neff's family's kitchen. And it was Jacob Barnes that put the paneling up and stained it with ox blood.
Oh.
He enlarged the windows and put glass in them because up until that point it was oilcloth on the windows.
And now would the Barneses have been considered wealthy for that time?
They were wealthy at that time. He was originally from Connecticut. He moved to Surrey, Virginia, where he met and married his wife, and he had accumulated money.
And what was his
business? He was a farmer.
A farmer.
He was
okay.
a farmer. And so when he came to Canfield, there's a little cutie pie thing where Canfield really didn't want him because he had 8 children in tow and they thought they would become wards of the city or something. So when he bought Loghurst, he paid with gold coin, proving he could support his large family. This is Conrad Neff's original sign that it hung out front of the home. And you could see C-N-A-F-F. And then years later when Jacob Barnes bought it, he reused the sign and put J-A-B-A-R-N-S. I'll just open the door to give you a shot. This is how they got upstairs, and it swings around the fireplace.
That looks a little steep.
It is very steep. This is set up the 1900s from Josephine's days here. Josephine was actually born in 1905 in the house, and her sister was born in 1908 in this house. This is how it would have looked in the 1900s. The carpeting in this room and that room is original to the Kyle family, along with Josephine's pump organ.
You really are the historian for Trumbull County, which used to be all of
northeastern Ohio.
Exactly.
And of course, we did a lot of research and preparation into land deeds and titles in order to identify who these different families are, you know, what was their connection to Canfield.
So you really can gain a lot of knowledge from
right.
just reading the tombstones, huh?
And then to go to a library and research an obituary. Now, after the Civil War, obituaries became a little more lengthy
mm-hmm.
and gave history. The early ones just said, born such and such a date and a place and died.
Yes,
and
you get more information on
so
the family.
The later ones give you much more information.
So where should we begin our tour?
Well, I think we should point out Martin and Catherine Neff, who were both buried in the mausoleum. Yep. And the mausoleum was discontinued for use. Descendants of the families were encouraged to remove the remains and bury them in the regular family plots in the cemetery. Now, Catherine Neff was the first burial coffin to be placed in that. She didn't get her remains put in there until 2 years after she died.
When did they choose to close the mausoleum?
In the early 40s.
And now that's for storage purposes?
Well, it was sealed off because, of course, there were some descendants of burials in that mausoleum that they couldn't find any relatives.
Bruce Neff is also a member of the Historical Foundation, and how you have so many family members here.
Right. Well, I never knew that growing up, but now that I'm approaching the age where I'm going to be horizontal in this.
Are you going to be with your people?
I'm going to be with my people. It's right over here.
So this is the newer section.
Yeah, that's the newer section. But this is my grandmother and grandfather, Roy and Laura Neff, and my and their oldest son, Charles, and his wife, Evelyn Neff.
And then that would have been your aunt and uncle.
Aunt and uncle, yep.
Now, Jacob was reportedly buried in the farm cemetery in a vertical position, standing up. And the myth was that he wanted to be ready to escape in case the devil came or the Underground Railroad slave catchers, that he could make a fast exit from where he was being followed.
Well, I gotta tell you, the members of this foundation, you really know your stuff with the Canfield history. And it's really living history. You do the cemetery walks. There's all kind of activities up at Loghurst. And I really appreciate your time.
Well, thank you so much for coming out and letting us talk to you.
Well, I feel so badly that I live right nearby and I don't know anything about the history that's all around me.
Uh-huh. Well, come again.
You are a wealth of knowledge. And make sure go to their website or give them a call to find out more activities for the Heritage Foundation.